So to give you an example of the kinds of effects that are available, again, on Windows, on Macintosh, we can blur the effects, do color keying, monochrome. You can do transitions like blinds or dissolve. Right. You can set the speed. Again, more than 50 effects and transitions that are available, and they're just components that you use in your application. And you can write code to trigger them, or you can go and specify for each of them. When you mouse over it, to do a hover effect, or when it gets focus. Again, this works on 32-bit, 64-bit, and Macintosh. For C++, 32-bit, and Macintosh as well. Now, what it requires is a... A GPU, a graphics processor or graphics card that's been around for, let's say, the last 8 years. We say Pixel Shader 2.0 API available. So if there's a DirectX 9 driver for your graphics card or graphics chip, you can get all this high definition in 3D. If you have a very old system, you can still do 2D FireMonkey applications, but you can't, there's no effects. It'll still render the edit boxes, the check boxes, the list boxes, and so on. Fully contained, super components, just no effects, no animations. Those need the GPU. So in RAD Studio XC2, we have updated support for the latest versions of the databases for SQL. Many of you ask for other databases. What about FileMaker? What about other things? So we now have a DB Express driver that can talk through ODBC drivers. So if you've got a database, a files application that isn't a SQL database that we support, if you have an ODBC driver, you can still use the SQL connection component, the SQL data set operation components, with your database, simply by setting the connection string of the ODBC driver as the connection string of your SQL connection component. All right. We also have third-party partners like DevArt has a Postgres SQL DB Express driver and a SQLite DB Express driver. So there are many other drivers out there for databases that we don't support specifically. You can build your web service applications, your data snap applications. You can connect to multi-tier systems through SOAP and RESTful web service calls. All of that is available. Again, your applications can be put wherever. We have compilers to support them. We also have support in this version for using storage in Microsoft Azure, which we had in XE, we now also support Amazon S3 storage for blobs, tables, and queues through one set of components. So you can choose to have alternative storage that you connect to. If you've built DataSnap servers, we have updated DataSnap to support the generation of additional languages and language interfaces to call the methods of your DataSnap server. So in DataSnap in XC, We have support for Delphi clients, C++ clients, PHP clients, Prism clients, and JavaScript clients. Right? In RadStudio XE2, we also now will generate the interface source code for Objective-C for iOS-based clients, Java for BlackBerry, Java for Android, and C# for Windows Phone 7 clients. So if you've exposed methods or metadata and data calls in your DataSnap servers, you now have more options to build clients that can talk to your DataSnap servers that are written in Delphi and C++ Builder. Right. And we've added capabilities to DataSnap as well. We'll talk more about those this afternoon in the deep dive. But we give you more control, including HTTPS support, control over client connections so that you can authenticate clients, you can throttle how many connections are coming from clients, you can shut down clients, all at the DataSnap server level. You can monitor connections, you can log connections, you can keep connections alive even if the client goes away for a while. There's a keep alive property in DataSnap XE2. So when a client connects, if they disconnect for some reason, maybe it's a mobile client, for example, moving between cell towers, or a client that loses network connectivity temporarily for a microsecond, a second, a few seconds, the server can keep the connection alive so that when the client comes back, it has the same session ID. You control that through keep alive properties in DataSnap. If you want to build PHP server-side applications with clients that are AJAX-enabled, browser-based, we've added additional support for components, the Zend framework, all the interfaces. We also have support for jQuery mobile JavaScript components so that you can build in a browser the same kind of look and feel that you would see on a mobile device. The vertical wipes, the moving from screen to screen smoothly in a browser. We also support generating native client applications for iOS and Android, taking the client-side part of your PHP application and using PhoneGap to create native applications for iOS and Android. So the wizard goes and pulls the client parts, the JavaScript, HTML, and CSS parts of your PHP application, and it compiles them for iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, and Android tablets and phones. Your PHP server side still runs on the server. And then AJAX calls take place between your native client now, or your browser client, to your PHP server. Let's take a quick look. And then there's more deep dive to come.